Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can save articles to read later in Safari. So sometimes when you're browsing the web, you come across an article that you want to read, but you don't have time to read it right now. You want to save it for later. Now, you may be tempted to bookmark that web page, but bookmarking is more for when you permanently want to save that page so you can go back to it over and over again. If you just want to read something later, then a better choice is the Safari reading list. So here I am in Safari, and I'm looking at an article, and I want to save it to read later. The way to do that is to go to Bookmarks, but instead of adding a bookmark, go to Add to Reading List. Note the keyboard shortcut is Shift-Command-D. Go to Add this to the reading list, and you can see it kind of disappears into the sidebar here. I can show the sidebar by clicking here, and if I look at the bottom, I'll see Reading List. If I click that, I'll see my reading list, including the article I just saved. A quicker way to get there is usually to go to View and then Show Reading List Sidebar, or Control-Command-2. If you choose that, it brings you not just to the sidebar, but instead of showing new bookmarks or some other section of the sidebar, it always takes you right to the reading list. So let's say later on I see another article and I want to add that one as well. I'll use Shift-Command-D to add it to the reading list. And then maybe here's a third page. I use Shift-Command-D to save that as well. Now when I use Control-Command-2 to bring up the reading list, I can see all three of those articles there. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MacMost at Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. There are other ways to add to the reading list. For instance, you can Control-click, right-click, or two-finger-click on a trackpad on a link. And one of the options here is to add the link to your reading list. But you could also just hold the Shift key down and then click, and that will add to the reading list as well. Another way to add is when you're on a web page, you can use the Share button here or File, Share. And one of the options here is Add to Reading List. Now you view the reading list here in the left sidebar. There are actually two modes here. If I were to use two fingers on my trackpad or one on a magic mouse and scroll down, you could see the modes are all for all of the articles in your reading list or just the unread ones. Once you select one here and then read through it, it's going to mark it as read and it won't show here in this mode, but all your articles will show here. Also notice there's search here at the top. So if your reading list gets long, you can search by something in the title or the URL. Like for instance, I can find all of the Wikipedia articles by searching. There is one other way to get to your reading list. If you go to your start page, and you may have this set as your home page, so you may see it all the time, one of the sections here is reading list. If I click edit at the bottom right, I can customize this. If I'm just interested in seeing the reading list here, I could uncheck everything but reading list, and then my start page turns into a reading list page. And when you're done with something and you want to remove it from the reading list, you can bring up the context menu and use delete here to delete that item. But you can use two fingers on a trackpad or one on a mouse and swipe to the left to reveal buttons here. One of them is remove. If you swipe the other direction, you can mark something as read or unread, so it will or will not appear in the unread section. You can also control click on the start page and you can delete there as well to remove something from the reading list. Now that's how to add and maintain your reading list, but how do you actually read the articles? Well, if you select one here, like this one, it simply loads the page up again, like if you were using a bookmark. But there are a couple of interesting aspects. One is that if you scroll through this article and get all the way to the bottom and then push past the bottom, you actually end up in the next article on the list. It actually works out as a continuous scroll. I can do the same thing by scrolling back up. I can scroll to the previous article and then all the way to the top. So you can use your reading list as one long continuous page. Now there's another feature in Safari with the word read in it, and that's reader or reader view. You can find it by going to view and then show reader. And this works on any page that's mostly an article. Pages with lots of graphics or videos and stuff won't have this feature, but articles will. And you can use this menu command or Shift-Command-R to go into Reader View, which looks like this. just gets rid of a lot of the distractions and leaves you with the text. You can customize Reader View by clicking here at the top. And now you can choose a basic theme like this. You can choose from different fonts. You can zoom more like that and also use this to exit Reader View. This makes it a lot easier to read articles. And notice that if I now scroll past the bottom of this article here, the next one appears in Reader View as well. If your Mac is compatible with Apple Intelligence and you have it enabled, you may also see some other things here, like a table of contents with links and a summarize feature that summarizes the article using AI. Now, on any web page, you can go to Edit Speech and have it start speaking the contents of the page. But usually there are so many different elements on a web page, it doesn't make sense. But once you have Reader View enabled, then using Start Speaking will produce a better result. And if you like, you can actually just select text and then use the context menu here and then Speech, Start Speaking to just speak that section. So you can skip over portions of it if you like. Now, a special feature of the reading list is the ability to save an article to view it offline. Notice if I swipe to the left here, not only do I get a remove button, but a save offline button there. And the idea is then that this article will be cached. And if I'm disconnected from the internet, I can still go to my reading list selected here and I can read the article. There's even a setting to make this the default. Go into Safari, Settings, go to Advanced, and then right here, you've got Save Articles for Offline Reading Automatically. So now you don't have to remember to select that. Anything added to your reading list is going to be available offline. Another big feature of reading list is it works over iCloud. So as long as you have Safari enabled with iCloud on all your devices, adding items to your reading list on one device means they'll show up on the other. So on your iPhone, to get to your reading list, you would tap the bookmark button there. And you could see there are three sections here. You've got bookmarks, and on the right, there's history. In the middle there, you've got the glasses that represent the reading list. Select that, and then you could see the different articles that you've saved there synced across using iCloud. You've got show unread here. You can swipe to the left and to the right, just like you can on the Mac. You can also select edit here to select some and then delete. You've got the save offline option. When you're reading, you have the ability to tap here to the left side of the address bar, and you can switch to Reader View, just like on the Mac. And then tap here again, and you have all the different options for fonts and themes. And then there's a handy button here to actually have the page spoken to you, just like on the Mac as well. Adding something to the reading list is a matter of tapping on the share button here. And then one of the options is add to reading list. But you can also tap and hold a link and you'll find add to reading list is an option there as well. Now, there are a lot of third-party apps out there that let you save articles for offline reading. And one of the things that they all have that you don't really have with the reading list is organization. You can't group them. You can't put them in folders or anything like that. But there are alternatives. For instance, you can use bookmarks instead. If you don't mind not having them saved for offline view, then you can create bookmarks, create folders for your bookmarks, and organize as you like, even changing the titles to match what you might be searching for later. Also, remember here at the top, you've got search. Search can act as a substitute for organization. Just let the list accumulate articles and use search later to find something from a particular site or to search for a term or look for a keyword. And remember, you always have the option to save an article outside of Safari. You can go to File and you can export as a PDF, for instance. But also note that if you go to Reader View and then you do the same thing, then you're going to get a Reader View version of that as a PDF. So here's that first PDF here, and here is the Reader View version of the PDF. And if you want something to look exactly like it does on the web, you can always go to File, Save As, and then set the format to save as a web archive. So here's the web archive of this, and you can see it looks exactly like the page. Personally, I use Reading List when I know I want to go back to a web page to read something, and then I'm probably going to be done with it. If I know I want to save it and refer back to it many times in the future, I'll save a bookmark. But you don't always have to decide right away. You can save something to the reading list, go back to read it, and then bookmark it after you decide you want to keep the article around longer. If the web page is something I really want to keep as is permanently, then I will save it usually as a PDF. So as you can see, Safari gives you a variety of tools to save web pages as you like, depending on the situation. Hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching. We'll be right back.